Hello, this is Trevor, and today I'm going to cover how to set up Udim textures, how to handle RGB pack textures, height and normal maps, and last but not least, how to set up subsurface scattering for your character inside Unreal Engine 5.5. It's going to be an easy tutorial, so let's start this. Okay, so before importing my character, I need to enable virtual texture support in the project settings. Since I'm currently using Udim textures, if you use normal ones, you don't have to do that, but this will allow us to use Udim textures. Okay, now let's import our character now. In 5.5, import settings interface changed a bit visually, but mainly it's the same. Let's organize that a bit and let me create the materials for the other parts, and it's them. So let's start creating the material, open it up. So there is two ways for PVR texturing workflow, one with simple unpegged separated maps, which I use in Blender, and the other one is channel pegged maps. In Unreal you typically want to go with the pegged maps for optimization, since fewer textures file reduce GPU memory and texture streaming costs and so on. It means that the AO, roughness and metallic are all pegged to one single texture, to each channel, red, green and blue. In my texture breakdown video, I didn't explain the exporting settings because I know I will do this video at some point. So let's jump back in time and let me show you quickly what to look out for. So as you can see, we have the usual Blender principle setup, which contains simple maps. Obviously, this is a separated version, which is totally fine and you can work with it as well, but it's just better if it's pegged. And it's important to look out for the normal map type as well, because Unreal wants a DirectX normal, and as you can see, it's OpenGL. If we change this to Unreal pegged, you can see that the normal is now DirectX. We have to keep this in mind. Basically, what it means is that the green channel of the normal map is flipped. Here's a reference, so you will understand. So with that in mind, let's jump back to Unreal. If you happen to have a DirectX map, then if you open the texture up, you can flip the green channel. So no worries if you have that. Look for a green and tick it in and save it. But if you exported your texture with Unreal pegged from Substance, then your normal doesn't need any change. Another thing we need to do is to open up the pegged texture and tick off RGB, since even though it's pegged in channels, behind the scenes they are still just simple grayscales. For grayscale textures like roughness, metallic or AO, unchecking RGB ensures Unreal only process the necessary data and significantly reduce GPU memory usage and improving performance. So if you have a single texture, just plug them in the right place. If you have pegged, then the red is for AO, blue is for metallic, and green is for rough unless you change that. Now you most probably will receive an error like this, and here down below you can see what is the error. And that is that the texture has to be virtual linear color, since we turned off RGB. And now it's all good. Same case with the others as well, as you can see. Okay, I have one final texture, which is the height map, which is basically a curvature map from Substance, but there is no place for it, so what we can do here is we can combine it with the normal map. To do that, hold one and left click to add a constant. Type in, for example, 0.3. Next, look for a normal from height map node. Connect the constant to the normal map intensity. Now, if you try to plug in the texture, it will not work, so we have to do it in another way. So look for a texture object. In this texture object, look for the height map. Then you will be able to connect it. Now look for this node, blend angle corrected normals. Now connect the normal map to the base normal and the height to the additional normal, and connect the result of the normal. We can also turn off RGB on this one, save it, then change it to virtual linear color. And now as you can see, the material preview is already there. With this value we can increase or decrease its strength. But we will not do it here, we will create a material instance in the end, so we can change it in real time in our character. It starts looking good, but our character is still missing a huge part which will give some life to it, and that is subsurface scattering. Now there is multiple ways of achieving that. I'm going to show you quickly four versions that you can consider. I keep the best for last, so feel free to skip them. So the first one is purely node-based, so this is what you have to set up. Two constraints and one texture constant. With 3 and left click you can add it, then change this to subsurface. Connect the first one to the opacity, give the texture a divide node, then connect the other constant to the B, then connect it to the subsurface color. Change it to some reddish color, name them. First is strength, second is brightness. You can tweak the values, and this is how it would look. It could work on a single piece as well, but in my case it's not really good. Next technique would be to use a simple red flashlight texture of the character, which you can create in Substance or Blender with veins and everything. Well, this can be great and give you great control on how the subsurface should look. It's really hard to get it right, since you might have to go back and change the texture if you don't like it. So this setup just needs one constant, connect it to the opacity, again convert to parameter, then connect the texture to the color, You can tweak the brightness and other values inside of the texture, or you can tone it down a bit with nodes. But I consider this the hardest solution. Next is the subsurface texture packed version. Now this is a bit weird one, so I hold back the substance to show you what exactly is that texture and how to do it. So here in this tab, you should enable subsurface scattering parameters, so you can actually see some results. Here you should add a new channel, scattering. Now it's there at every material, you just have to enable them. I already made something here for reference, so it's kind of weird because the darker areas are more transparent in this case. Since there is not yet a great documentation on how to set up this correctly, I found that this is how it should work. So you plug in the RGB to the base color, alpha to the opacity, and the last one to the subsurface color. And with some divide node or with some constant, you can modify the strength. But I really not recommend this method. So the last one, the ace of aces, is the subsurface profile. This is what I'm going to use. It's far the most easiest, I believe. You may have come across with this at the meta events and you were like,
what the hell is even that?
But it's just looking scary, it's not actually. At the material, select your node, then select subsurface profile this time. Go to the content browser and under material, look for profiles, then select subsurface profile. Name it. If you open it up, automatically, it will give you a Caucasian color for scattering. But I'm going to tweak that a little bit anyway. The material, select the profile we just created, add a constant, convert it to a parameter, then name it subsurface amount or strength, and type in a value of 0.3, for example. Now let's create a material instance and change it to this in the materials slot. Save everything, place your character in the scene or just hit play. And the first thing you notice that there is nothing happening is because the light in the scene has to have a transmission enabled. So let's just do that. Look for your main light source. Save it. And now it's perfectly working. And now you can modify it in real time while the panels are open. Let's tone this down to 0.2. And let's change some values here. Let's start with the mean free pass distance. Look out not to make a vex figure, so don't go overboard with this value. You can change some overall roughness. You can set a low mix, which can act like sweating. Let's change the color to a bit darker one. Looking good. How about the other one? Okay, that works for me. I think it's just superior compared to the others. And it seems like we are done. Just in case someone is following around, I still owe you one texture setup, and that is the eyebrows and eyelashes from the hair card creation tutorials. So this is how you set it up in Unreal. It's pretty easy. Turn on double-sided. Change this to mask. Plug it into the opacity mask. Turn the midmap to 0 full resolution, so it won't get downgraded in the distance. Or additionally, you can tweak it, but it's already a low resolution texture and this is a main character, so I don't see any point of doing that. You can create a material instance out of it, or metallic and rough and spec adjustment. But that's all basically. So that is it for today. I hope it helped. If it did, please leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you on the next one.